forge us as a community to follow the path Jesus has marked for us. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Barb. We welcome you, and we welcome Amy Rose this morning as well as our musician for worship. We don't have a hymn packet, and we won't be using the hymnals because the songs that she's singing don't include, or aren't included in our packet or the hymnals. So please just hum along, sing along if you know some of them, and worship as we listen to her beautiful music she shares. Her prelude this morning is Word of God Speak.
Finding myself at a loss for words, and the funny thing is, it's okay. Last thing I need is to be heard, but to hear what you say. Word of God, speak. Will you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know and your endless place. Please let me stay in your holiness. Word of God, speak. Finding myself at a loss for words, beyond the music, beyond the noise, all that I need is to be with you and in the quiet hear your voice, word of God, speak. Would you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know your endless grace. Please let me stand here in your holy God, of God's grace. For you pour down like rain, washing my eyes to see your majesty, to be still and know in your holy word of God speak. Finding myself at a loss for words, and the something is, it's so okay.
Come, all those who are tired, and meet the one who gives peaceful rest. Come, all who feel they do not have enough in life, and meet the one who satisfies. Come, all who feel they have no hope for the future, and meet the one who gives hope. Come, all who are searching for the answers in life, and meet the answer. Come, let us worship our God.
Thank you.
Beautiful Lord, wonderful Savior, I know for sure all of my days are held in your hands, crafted into your perfect hand. You gently call me into your presence, guiding me by your Holy Spirit. Teach me, dear Lord, live all of my life through your I'm captured by your holy calling. Set me apart. I know you're drawing. You make yourself. Leading Lord, I pray. Hey. Into your presence, I will be back. Your Holy Spirit, teach me, dear Lord, to follow my life through your power. I'm captured by your Holy Spirit.
Let us join in with the prayer of confession. Creator God, we confess that we fail to recognize the bounty around us. We are not satisfied. We have never enough. We consider what we have received and what we have generated and label it too, rather not too little. insufficient. We need to cultivate our imagination and our faith to observe abundance and opportunity rather than scarcity and deficiency. Help to comprehend that in your kingdom, the fragments you gather are more than enough for creation. Amen. Beloved, you are enough. God's grace, strength, love, and hope meet you with sufficiency. Through the Holy One's sustaining power, we can gather the fragments that make our lives beautiful and God's kingdom real in the world. Thanks be to God. Let us turn our hearts and minds in prayer. Almighty God, we give you thanks for this gorgeous opportunity to be outside in your creation, to hear the word, to hear the sounds of nature, to feel the ground underneath our feet, to sit in comfy chairs, to be presented with wonderful words of music, to come here to listen, to learn, and then to go forth from this place into our busy lives, lives of work, lives of leisure, lives of being with family and friends. We just ask you for safe traveling mercies, for being with us, whatever we do, that your name may be praised over and over again. We don't take anything for granted. That we pray for more rain, but we thank you for the dew that was on the grass this morning. We pray for the farmers who are trying to get their hay and everything in and get their soybeans planted and that the corn may continue to grow. But we know, God, in your world there are so many who go hungry, so many that don't have fresh, clean water. Those that have to make hard decisions day in and day out about what bills to pay, what food to buy. We live in a land of plenty. There are many who do not have enough to survive day by day. Be with this church. It's a ministry that are extensions of this church. Through the power program, through the Gettysburg Association, through the Penn Central Conference of the United Church of Christ. It doesn't have to be grandiose. Every little thing adds up. And if we trust in miracles and in you, we know that we can change things. We can change people. We can change lives. And so be with us as we continue to listen, to learn. As we go forth and we pray for all those who are struggling, whether it be in body, mind, or spirit. God, you know their needs. Those that are spoken and those that are unspoken. So continue to wrap your arms around those, lift up those who have lost loved ones. And whether it has been in the past week or the past month, 6 months, 15 years, 25 years ago, there is still that loss. And until we are all reunited in the great heavenly choir, allow us to continue to put one foot in front of the other, knowing that we will be reunited. But until that day comes, let us be about your work here and now. Regardless of our age, there is always something we can do. We can change something. We can pray for someone. We can listen. We can offer hope in a world that seems so fragmented, a world that seems so angry, a world that is obsessed with power and greed. Let us show them the ways of love and grace. And allow us to be your people, here and now in 2024 and in the years to come. For all this we ask in Christ's name, as we lift up those on our prayer list.
Dear Lord, we lift up these people in prayer. Karen and Robert Anstein, Diane Bond, Jean Falker, Fred Marsh, Gordon Markle, Tim Mathias, Neil Rohrbaugh, Matt Rupert, and Jerry Hsu Jr. We also remember the family and friends of Mary Dodson, Harold Kessler, Ruth Neller, Mildred Smith, and Phyllis Werner. Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Praying, our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Your offerings shall be mailed to Cindy Forbes at 5123 Simpson School Road, Springer, PA 17362. Sunday school offerings can be sent to Neil Rohrbaugh at 800 Mangus Mills Road, Springer, PA 17362. The church envelopes and offering plates are both right here on the bench. Let us sing our dedication song.
And would you rise as you're able and join with us?
invite the children to come forward at this time. For those in the Spring Grove School District, there's about 26 days left. I'm not counting for Josh to go back to school or anything yet, but you know. Anyhow, have you ever gone hunting for something?
You mean like looking?
Looking for something, yeah.
Like hunting.
Have you had to look for your parents? Or had they had to look for you?
Yes, definitely a lot.
Oh. So they know where to go to find you.
Yep.
If they can't find you any place else in the house, you're in your room reading a good book. What about you, Elijah? Do you have a favorite place to hide or hang out? No? Help me out with your name?
I guess I
will. What? Serenity. Do you have a favorite place to go? No? Okay. Well, when I got here, I put a pack of Tic Tacs out here. I need you guys to help me go find them.
Nope.
But you have to do this as a team. You can't be on your own. You have to do this together. And I'll give you hints like warmer, colder.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? So you got to stay together. I can't tell one cold, one hot. Things like that. Okay? So this is what you're looking for. And it's hidden out here in this area. Okay? It's not past those trees. It's not out there with those big kids. It's in this area. Okay? Go ahead. Oh, she's making a plan.
Yeah.
She's planning.
Oh, excuse me.
All right, you're pretty cool.
Let's try it on this side.
No, you're just about as cool there.
This would be a person.
Come on.
That's what I wasn't finding. This is the tape.
You're getting warmer distance-wise, but you're still cool. So Elijah's on the right track. Yep, he's getting warmer. Go with Elijah. It's covered up. It's not going to be easily seen.
Start digging, Elijah.
Start digging, Elijah. No. Oh, suspicious. They found it. All right. Under two leaves. I didn't want to make it too difficult, right?
Well, I think you made it look a bit too suspicious.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'll do better next time.
Hey, we do need scavenger hunts, though.
Oh, you like scavenger hunts?
Okay.
All right, well, I'll give you one, and then you can do it during my sermon sometime. How's that? Does that sound good? So you work together to find something.
Yeah.
And that's what the church is all about, coming together to do something bigger than what we can do by ourselves. Now, our gospel reading today is the feeding of the 5,000. So do you remember what the little boy brought for lunch that day?
Yep.
What?
5 loaves of bread and 2 fish.
Right, 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. And it fed over 5,000 people.
Surprising.
Surprising, because Jesus was involved.
Yeah.
Think about the church. We each come with our own things. And if we give it together, if we bless it and ask God to bless it, it goes out into the world and it can change things.
Okay.
Think about you serving at POW. How you reach those people making whatever food. If it's macaroni, or if it's barbecue, or if it's spaghetti, or...
Usually Chick-fil-A.
Chick-fil-A?
Yeah, they get...
Why don't you go there and make food?
We do.
Oh, but you give them Chick-fil-A too?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Chick-fil-A is...
Maybe Chick-fil-A sauce, I don't know.
Oh, sometimes sauce, sometimes not. Okay. But you have to make the food too, right?
Yes.
And then you parse it out to each of the individual containers, and then they can take it home, or they can eat there, right?
Yeah.
So you're feeding them, and you might be feeding their family who doesn't even come there. And think about the people that you're touching, and you're showing them, hey, this is God's love in action. You may not even say a word to them, but they see that in action. And that's what we're called to do and to be. changing the world one person at a time. Are we going to make a huge impact? Are we going to be in the Guinness World Book of Records? Probably not. But you never know. Never know. God works miracles all the time. So we have to be open to that. Let us pray. Almighty God, we ask you to watch over these, your children, and all the big kids that are here and those that are listening. Wrap your arms around them and give them your imagination. Give them ideas of what you want them to do, of how we can serve you faithfully each and every day. For this we ask in Christ's name. Amen.
Yes.
If I give you a box, you can share.
Sure.
There you go.
Thank you.
All right. Somebody can make sure this
works.
Save some for me. I love you, Lord.
I'm going to start this over. I was thinking about candy.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will say of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You've led me through the fire, and in darkest night you were close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful.
Your goodness is
From John chapter 6, verse 1 to 21. And it begins, "After this, Jesus went to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, also called the Sea of Tiberias. A large crowd kept following him because they saw the signs that he was doing for the sick. Jesus went up to the mountain and sat down there with his disciples. Now the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was near. When he looked up and saw the large crowd coming toward him, Jesus said to Philip, 'Where are we to buy bread for these people to eat?' He said this to test him, for he himself knew what he was going to do. Philip answered him, 6 months' wages would not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little.' One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, 'There's a boy here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they among so many people?' Jesus said, 'Make the people sit down.' Now there was a great deal of the grass in the place, so they sat down, about 5,000 in all. Then Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated. So also the fish, as much as they wanted. When they were satisfied, he told the disciples, 'Gather up the fragments left over, so that nothing may be lost.' So they gathered them up, and from the fragments of the 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten, they filled 12 baskets. When the people saw the sign that he had done, they began to say, 'This is indeed the prophet who is to come into the world.' When Jesus realized that they were about to come and take him by force to make him king, he withdrew again to the mountain by himself. When evening came, his disciples went down to the lake, got into a boat, and started across the lake to Capernaum. It was now dark, and Jesus had not yet come to them. The lake became rough because a strong wind was blowing. When they had rowed about 3 or 4 miles, they saw Jesus walking on the lake and coming near the boat, and they were terrified. But he said to them, 'It is I, do not be afraid.' Then they wanted to take them into the boat, and immediately the boat reached the land toward which they were going." This ends the reading.
Immediately after the fighting had stopped in World War II, American soldiers gathered up many hungry and homeless children and placed them in tent cities. Many of them were malnourished and in need of medical care. The soldiers shared their bread with them. However, the soldiers noticed one thing, that the children were afraid to go to sleep at night. So one of the soldiers tried an experiment after dinner. He gave the children a piece of bread to hold. The result was astounding. When they had the security of bread for tomorrow, they slept like babies. Bread. What comes to mind when you think of home-baked or homemade bread? Can you feel the smell? Can you taste it? Can you think about what it brings people together? Bread is holy food, not just when we celebrate communion, but in our day-to-day. We say in the Lord's Prayer, give us this day our daily bread. Bread is a food known throughout the world. There's also a fable tells of a young bear cub who was puzzled on how to walk. He asked an old she-bear, should I move my right paw first, or my left paw, or my two front paws, or my hind ones, or all four at once? How? In reply, the old she-bear growled, leave off the thinking and just walk. Sometimes that's what God says to us. Quit analyzing everything and scrutinizing everything and just get moving. Sit down and listen to me and let us go. Let us pray. Oh God, may the words of my mouth, may the meditations of all our hearts be truly pleasing and acceptable offering to you, you who are the rock and our great redeemer and the lover of our souls. Amen. You know there's new math out there, right? If you try to help your kids today in school, I call it the new math, and I don't know how it all works. But I have an equation here. 5 plus 2 times 1 equals 12. Now, most of you would say, well, she graduated from Spring Grove. She failed all the math courses. I graduated from Shippensburg University. She must have failed there, too. Graduated from seminary. Must have failed there as well. But if you take 5 loaves of bread plus 2 fish times Jesus equals 12 baskets left over. Whatever we have, whether it's 5, whether it's 150, whether it's 6, plus whatever else somebody else has, when we multiply it times Christ, we have an abundance. Do we believe that, or do we live as scarcity people, afraid of where is our next meal coming? For most of us, I don't live that way. I know that I have a cupboard full, and downstairs there's a cabinet. I have a freezer. The choices are, what am I going to make? Not, am I going to eat? But in many worlds, that's a choice that folks have to decide on. Each day they have to get up and they have to find food for that day alone. And think about Jesus' time. They heard Jesus and they saw him doing these miracles and they were following him. Let's get closer. Let's see what's next. And so there's a big crowd, 5,000 plus, because they only counted the men. So we're thinking maybe 10, 15,000 people were there. And Jesus says to his disciples, Philip, well, how are we going to feed them all? And Philip's probably thinking, oh my goodness, he's crazy. There's no way we can feed these. Plus, we don't have that much money. I mean, can you imagine going to your favorite restaurant and saying, oh, by the way, there's 5,000 people sitting out here in the parking lot. Can we feed them tonight? It doesn't happen. But think about your family. You have a get-together on holidays or picnics, and one of the grandkids says, hey, can I bring some friends over? And you're like, sure. And the other one says, can I bring some friends over? And you're like, sure, but now you're starting to think. All right, if he's going to bring 2 or 3, and he's going to bring 3 or 4, maybe I need to add a little bit more fruit to that fruit salad to spread it out. Or if you're having a meal like mashed potatoes, maybe you add a little bit more milk and you thin it out. Has there ever been a time where a church gets together and we run out of food? There's always enough. And think about the potlucks. Have you ever had a potluck where everybody just brings dessert? No! It would be okay, yes, but it doesn't happen because everybody's thinking about something different, a salad or a dessert or maybe a bread item or a drink. How does that ever work? There's no great planner saying, you need to bring this, you need to bring that. It just happens. And imagine that happening in God's creation. We all show up and we give what we have and God multiplies that and takes that and uses that for others. Maybe in this community, maybe outside this community, maybe outside of our know the changes that we can do, but we're called to plant seeds. I mean, think about the things that Jesus used as his illustrations. The mustard seed, the lost coin, tiny things. He didn't talk about something big and grandiose. He took little things and multiplied them. And that's what we're called to do, to show up, to be here, to be present, to listen, and to take time with God. Can you imagine having 5,000 people here in the picnic grove? And how would you control them? I mean, now we have a sound system. We could yell at them. But back in Jesus' time, how would you get the word out? I need to sit down in groups of 50. And there was a total of 12 disciples. Can you imagine them running around like chickens with their head cut off saying, sit down, sit down, sit down. But they did. And it's amazing. And when people sit down, I think sometimes they open up. Because if you're standing in line or you're milling around, you're always thinking about doing something else. But if you sit down, hey, I'm going to talk to you around you. Hey, how's it going? What's next? And so how do we today in 2024 change the world and be the church that God wants us to be? I've never thought about this, but as a sermon illustration, have you ever heard about hopping fleas and how they're trained? I'm told the fleas are put in a glass jar, and as they try and jump in the jar, they bump their heads on the lid. Well, over time, they forget they can jump, and for fear of bumping their heads, they never go beyond the limits of that jar. Even if they take the lid off, the fleas will only jump so high because they've been trained that way. Do we do things because we've been trained that way, but maybe God took off the lid and said, wow, let's try something new. And are we willing to do that? Do we believe that miracles happen? Do we believe that a lad's lunch, something his mother packed maybe for lunch and dinner, 5 small barley loaves, 2 fish, could feed so many? I mean, think about it. It's unbelievable, and it's a story that is in all 4 Gospels. So it had an impact on everyone. This was huge. Maybe some of the details are a little different. This is a miracle story. A story that needs to be shared over and over again. And let us not miss out on what God calls us to do. There's a story of Dr. G. Campbell Morgan, who went to visit a member of his church. And he was sad to learn that she was going to be evicted because she couldn't pay the rent. That was on a Saturday afternoon. So on Sunday morning, he went to the congregation and told them about this plight, and he collected enough money for the woman's rent. He could hardly wait to tell her the good news, so he went Monday morning first thing and hammered on the door, but there was no answer. He knocked again, but still no answer, and he went away feeling rejected. But he learned later that the lady had been home the whole time. She was afraid to answer the door because she thought she was being evicted. Are we afraid to open the door to see what God has in store for us? Let us not think we know the right answer. Let us be in prayer. Let us open ourselves. And is it something we've done before? Maybe, maybe not. But if God is in the midst of it, and we give God the honor and the glory and the praise, we can do whatever. You've all heard the story of Stone Soup. How a weary traveler was going along, and he found a rock, and he thought, it's nice, I'll take it along. And he went into a village, but no one offered him a bed, no one offered him any food, nothing. And so he had this idea, have you ever heard of stone soup? It's really yummy and tasty. I have this rock, but I need a pot. And someone goes and gets him a pot. Well, I could really use 2 buckets of water. And so someone goes and gets 2 buckets of water, and he puts it in, and he puts it over the fire, and he starts stirring it. You know what would be more tasty? Some carrots. And somebody goes and gets 6 carrots. Something else that might help, maybe some potatoes. Someone goes and gets potatoes. And goes on, and adds onions and meat and whatever else you would want in your soup. And there was enough for everybody, because everyone gave just
just a little. God gave it all, but it is ours to give back, because we have been entrusted with such a great and wonderful gift. The choice is ours. How do we live? How do we spend our money? How do we do this and that? We think about what God would want us to do. You only need a little faith to move from fear to openness and to change. Can we open our hearts? Can we change and find the miracles of God and live in the abundance of life that He has offered? John 6 allows us to go to sleep confident that Jesus provided enough loaves of bread for us to have life and to have it abundantly. God still watches over us into our future and for eternity. Whatever comes your way, trust and believe. God loves you and will always love you. Amen.
Please pray also for these people on our prayer list. Reverend Julie Beale, Merle Bortner, Jean Eckenrode, Ray and Gloria Henry, Reverend Dwight Mays, Inese Miller, Shirley Miller, Patricia Moore, Mike Reynolds, Ireland Sprinkle, Charles Manskoy Sr. Also for Megan Bladesip, Glossdell, Reverend Bruce and Rita Bouchard, Louise Hammond, Manuel Nunez, Tiffany Rudisil, Mark Skahan, Linda Spangler, Sherry Ann Trump, and also for Cindy Breeden, Emma Case, Dwayne Henry, Irma Neller, Woody, and Brittany Lear.
You are forsaken, I'm accepted, you are condemned. I'm alive and well, your spirit is within me, because you died and you rose again. I'm forgiven, because you are forsaken. I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm alive and well, your spirit is within me, because you died and you rose again. Amazing love, how can it be that you let a king will die for me? My joy to honor you in all I do, to honor you. I'm forgiven because you were forsaken. I'm accepted, you were condemned. I'm die for me. Amazing love. joy to honor you.
Amazing love.
My king would die for me.
Amazing
love, I know it's true, and it's my joy to honor you in all I do, to honor you in all I do, to honor.
God meets you amid the storms of life. God goes with you through the terrors of the night.
We are embraced by God's steadfast love. We will look up and not be afraid.
May Christ dwell in your hearts through faith. May the Holy Spirit strengthen your inner being.
To God be the glory in the church forever. May Christ be honored in all we say and do.
May you, according to the riches of God's glory, the presence of Christ, and by the power of the Spirit, be strengthened in your inner being, be rooted and grounded in love, and be filled with the fullness of God. To the Holy One, who by the power at work within us is able to accomplish abundantly far more than we can ever imagine, be glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus to all generations, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you so much, Barb, for joining us this Sunday, as you have faithfully, and we look forward to welcoming you again when you join us again. Thank you for your message. Thank you for putting in front of us what some of us already know, and we just needed that reminder. Thank you. It means a lot that you share the message as you do. Thank you to our tech team, especially Adam Marsh and Jake Barnhart. And is there anybody else who's behind the scenes?
Just us today.
Okay, these guys have got it. They've got a Zoom call out there connecting people who are not here in person with us, so we are glad that you're all joining us. They've got the telephone call that called out to some other folks who aren't able to be with us, and it looks like we've got over 10 people, maybe even about 20 people or more on those calls, so we welcome all of those people. And we especially thank Amy Rose for sharing her music with us today, and she has another postlude a little bit later. Thank you for enlivening worship, but also what seems like the Holy Spirit has really pulled together the songs that you selected and our scriptures for today. We're feeling very blessed. Thank you for sharing with us. Our flowers today are on the bench there. Please enjoy those. The paper mache there is given to the glory of God in honor of my grandson Gavin Smith's birthday, my daughter-in-law Brittany Smith's birthday, my husband Bobby Smith's birthday by Cindy Smith. Thank you, Cindy. We continue to collect items monthly. We're collecting school supplies now in July and in August, and you may place them in the donation center at the rear entry of the church building.
encourage you to share if you're able, and encourage others to share as you're able to. That could be any school supplies, pencils, markers, paper, glue sticks. We are continuing to collect for packing backpack items. If you're interested in helping to gather specific items for that, maybe talk with Sharon Marsh and she'll guide you. They always find some deals on sales. So they actually have a lot of supplies. We were packing some pencil boxes last Sunday. We got a lot done there. If you have any need for pastoral care, we just remind you that you can contact Fred Marsh. You can also contact Sue Barnhart or Mike and Gail Sterner. For example, if you're in the hospital, if you request a visit, or if there's health changes that you want to let church leadership know about, so that we can reach out to anybody or check up on them, you can contact Fred, Sue, or Mike and Gail, and they'll handle your concern with care and privacy and contact the correct member of our pastoral team if needed. Sometimes we can't tell as lay people if the members of that pastoral team are available or aren't available, or if they're called away, or if they're already taking care of a need, or they just are dealing with something else. So Fred and Sue and Mom and Dad can help with that as well. So next Sunday is August 4th. Here we are at the end of July. August 4th next week, we'll be here in the Picnic Grove, and August 11th, we're also planning to be out here in the Picnic Grove. We pray that you can join us and worship together, and we'll see you then. Thank you. Could I ask you to share about that then? I don't want to misspeak.
Today, starting at 2 o'clock, there is a concert of the four local bands. Birdbeck's band is one of them. It is going to be held at Zion Lutheran, which is in West York. I think the concert goes on until 5 o'clock. So each band is going to have their own time to play, and then they're all going to play together. So if you want to listen to a lot of good music, go out and go to Zion Lutheran. And you can, I'm not sure what the web address is, but you can go online and find that. I think it's also on the Birdbeck's, Alan, I don't know if you correct me, it's also on the Birdbeck's band website, the location.
Thank you, Lorelei. That sounds like a really nice event. All right, we pray that you go in peace and have a wonderful week, and share with others the message of Christ. Thanks, Mindy. I completely forgot to thank you, Lorelei, for leading our worship. Sometimes our worship leaders are so seamless and jump right in, and thank you for leading us and for joining in and offering those names for the prayer list as well. I didn't want to forget you. Thank you.
I speak the name of Jesus over you, in your hurting, in your sorrow, I'll ask my God to move. I speak the name 'cause it's all that I can do. In desperation I'll seek heaven and pray this for you. I pray for your healing, circumstances would change. I pray that the fear inside would flee in Jesus' name. I pray that a breakthrough would happen today. I pray miracles over your life in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I speak the name of all authority, declaring blessings, every promise He's faithful to keep. I speak the name no grave could ever hold. He is greater, He is stronger, He's the God of possible. I pray for your healing. change. I pray that the fear inside would flee in Jesus' name. I pray that a breakthrough would happen today. I pray miracles over your life in Jesus' name. I pray for revival, a restoration of faith. I pray that the dead will come alive in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Close out of dial pads unless you have it maxed out. Okay, yeah, I gotcha.